powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
Welcome to this life-changing broadcast today as we receive the engrafted word of God that have the ability to empower us and inspire us to take the lead in the direction of God's will. And today we'll be sharing on Speak to the Wind. Well, creation. As new creation in Christ Jesus, we have the authority to address nature. We have the authority to speak to nature. You know, some people think we can speak to the sun, or to the moon, or to the wind, or to the tsunami, or to the storms of life. We have authority to speak to the wind. Whatever the wind is in life, whatever the situation may be in the natural, we have authority in Christ Jesus to speak to any situation. I'd like us to look at this in Mark Gospel chapter 4. I'd like us to read from verse 35. St. Mark Gospel chapter 4, verse 35. And the same day, when the evening was come, he said unto them, let us pass over unto the other side. And when they have sent away the multitude, they took him in a ship, and there were with other little ships, and there arose a great storm. I like to read it again. Mark chapter 4, verse 36. And when they were sent away, the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship, and there were also with him other little ships. Verse 37 said, and there arose a great storm. This is, they never expected that to happen. There arose a great storm. There was a great storm that was in operation. There arose a great storm. Jesus and his men were not expecting this storm. They just want to cross over. But there arose a great storm. But let's look at the attitude of Jesus. Let's read verse 37. Said, and there arose a great storm of wind, and the wave beat into the ship, so that they are now full. The wind beat into the ship. The wind beat into the ship. Asleep on a pillow, and they wake him and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Now, this is a problem. It's a natural problem. The wind came. The storm came. But the next thing I saw was Jesus exercising authority over the wind. Exercise, because the disciples called him, and the verse 39 said, and he arose and rebuked the wind. This is what we expected to do, to rebuke the wind. Whatever kind of wind that has come into your life or around you, in Christ Jesus, we have what it takes to rebuke the wind. Now, why did Jesus do that? Jesus have to do that because if he don't, something is going to go wrong. He may lose his disciples. People, it's going to overflow and things are going to go wrong. But Jesus exercised spiritual authority over the situation. And this is what it takes to reign in life. If you can't speak to whatever natural situation, maybe you heard that the rain was coming heavy and the place begins to flood. You don't need to wait for it to get to you. You can address the rain. You can address the flood. You can address the tsunami. When you hear, oh, a tsunami is coming to this state, you can begin to talk to that tsunami. You can begin to talk to that flood. You can begin to talk to that situation that will lead to natural disaster. You can begin to talk to that earthquake. We can speak to nature. When God begins to talk to me about this morning, he said a lot of his people are waiting for him to rebuke nature for them when they are expected to exercise their authority over the situation, and he was going to establish, confirm his word. But most people are waiting for God to rebuke the wind for them. This is what the disciples did here. They waited for Jesus to rebuke the wind. But that same authority Jesus have, they could have walked in the same authority. And that was why Jesus said here in verse 40, Mark 4 verse 40 said, and he said unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith? He was talking to them. He wasn't happy that he was the one doing it for them. He expected Peter, he expected John or Andrew to stand up and say, wind, I want you to stop right now in the name of Jesus, or wind, I want you to stop right now in the name of the Lord. None of the disciples said anything. Either they were afraid, they were scared, they were frustrated, then they run to Jesus. Now Jesus rebuked the wind. Look at what the Bible said in verse 39. It said, and there arose, and he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea. That simply means we can talk to the sea. We can talk to rain, we can talk to sun, we can talk to creation. Whatever God has created, we can speak to it because we are new creations in Christ Jesus. We have authority to speak to things. We have authority to speak to things. If you don't speak to those things may come and cause you more problems. This is where there are people, the storm was coming, the wind was coming, they never spoke to it, they were scared, and you know what happened? The wind came and took their roof off. Their roof went off. The rain came and flooded, and their whole house were drenched, and things went wrong. We can speak to natural disasters before they happen. We can speak to nature. We can speak to situations. So whenever you see a situation in the natural and you look at it and say, well, this is a horrible situation. This is not good. You can say, in the name of Jesus, I command this storm to stop. In the name of Jesus, I command this wind to cease. In the name of Jesus, I command this cloud to move to move in the right direction. In the name of Jesus, I command the storm, the wind. You know, so if we don't speak to the situations around us, those situations could affect our dream or our vision. So this is why we need to learn to walk in authority. As sons of God, as believers in Christ Jesus, we need to learn to walk in our authority, because if we don't, we can't be able to make a difference. So speak to your situation. Whatever the situation may be, in the natural, in your dream, in your assignment, you must learn to speak to the situation. You must learn to speak to the circumstances. Whatever it is, we have authority. We have authority in Christ Jesus to deal with the storms of life. We have authority in Christ Jesus to deal with any opposition. Can I say this to you, people of God? Christ has given us authority, and he expects us to utilize the authority. I want to say it one more time again. I said Christ has given us authority and he expects us to utilize the authority. He has given us authority. Jesus spoke to the wind. Jesus did not say, well, what will be, will be. Jesus did not say, oh, what will happen, what will be, will be. No, that was not what he said. He arose and he rebuked the storm. He was exercising spiritual authority over the situation. This is what you do in your life. Whenever a situation comes that is far beyond your human ability, you have to speak to it. You have to address it. Most situations we deal with in the natural has a spiritual connection. Unknowing to most people, they don't have this idea. Most situations in the natural has a spiritual connection. Most situations that people are trying to address from a natural perspective has a spiritual tie that has a potential to destroy the individual. This is why Jesus arose and spoke to the wind. He spoke to that storm. Look at it here in Mark Gospel chapter 4, verse 39. And he arose and rebuked the wind. I like this. He arose and rebuked. Jesus did not say, well, what will be. Maybe it's the will of God that the wind come to us. Or maybe it's the will of God. Maybe God wants to teach us something through this wind that came. Maybe God wants us to have the wind. And you know that this wind has a potential to destroy the ship. This wind had the potential to destroy the lives of people. This wind had the potential to cause people to lose their goods or their products, whatever they have. You know, but Jesus arose and rebuked the wind. This is the kind of spiritual stand we need to have as sons of God. That whenever anything comes up, we should be alert in the spirit to address it spiritually. We shouldn't say, well, Lord, we'll hand it over to you. While you're saying, Lord, you hand it over to the Lord, you have to speak the word of God over that situation. If you don't exercise authority over situation, over the wind of life, over the storms of life, you're going to lose that. We must learn to exercise authority over nature. You must learn. You know, we had this terrible rain in my city some few days back. That was like 3 days ago. It was on Saturday, Sunday. You know, this rain was heavy. We haven't seen it like that before. It was so heavy that some part of my city started flooding. Vehicles were covered. You know what I did? I came out at the maybe 2 a.m. my time while that rain was falling. And I said, Father, in the name of Jesus, I take authority over this rain. Rain, I speak to you, become in the name of Jesus. I started speaking to the atmosphere. I started addressing the issue. I was done. I went back to the bed. The next day, 2 days later, I started hearing about people who lost their babies in the wind, by the rain, people who lost their children, people who lost their properties, people who lost things. Now, and that's, the word of the Lord dropped in my spirit. He said, if you have not spoken to that rain, your home could have been flooded. If you have never stood and addressed the situation, most times some Christians are passive. They just look at things, well, it's not going to get near me. I'm a believer in Christ Jesus. It's not my portion. No, address the situation. Address the situation. Learn to address. Jesus did not say, oh, the wind is not going to get near me. Oh, I'm the son of God. The wind. He addressed it. Look at God in Genesis 1 verse 2. He said, Genesis 1 verse 2, he said, there was darkness upon the face of the deep and the spirit of God moved. And we saw God in Genesis 1 verse 3, he said, and God said, let there be light. Why is God speaking? God spoke with authority and enforced the light. And enforced the light. And this is the kind of mentality we need to have as sons of God. This is the kind of mentality we need to have as sons of God. And he spoke to the wind. He spoke to the wind. He said, in the name of Jesus. You know, when we use the name of Jesus to speak to situations, situations change. Situations change. You have to address the situation before you in the name of Jesus. You have to address whatever it is, whether it has to do with your health, it has to do with your job, it has to do with your relationship. If you don't address it in the name of Jesus, you cannot enjoy your victory. You cannot enforce your victory. We enforce our victory by speaking the word of God. How do we enforce our victory? We enforce our victory by speaking the word of God. If we don't speak God's word, we cannot enforce our victory. Victory comes when we speak the word of God. So Jesus, I was look at that scripture in Mark Gospel chapter 4, verse 39. And he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace be still. He spoke. He said to the sea, peace be still. As believers in Christ Jesus, we have to be spiritually minded and having this understanding that most things we deal with in the natural has a spiritual connection. We need to have this mentality that most things people deal with in the natural, they may be dealing with this, oh, this person is going through paralysis, you know, or what could cause paralysis is she's suffering from paralysis, you know, and we are addressing it from a natural point of view. But let me say this to you, paralysis have a spiritual connection. There are demons that cause people to be paralyzed, I'm telling you. There are demons that cause people's body to shut down. So if you don't know how to exercise your authority, you must learn to take authority. In the name of Jesus, I speak to my body. In the name of Jesus, I bind every spirit responsible for this activity. You see, if we fail to speak, we're going to lose by default. If we fail to speak the word of God, we will lose by default. If we fail to speak God's word, the enemy will take advantage of our ignorance. This is why the word of God said, give no place to the devil. How do we give a place to the devil? It's when we are ignorant of the word of God concerning the situation. When we are ignorant of God's word concerning the situation. When you're ignorant of the word of God concerning the situation, then you get into trouble. You begin to lose. The enemy will come in if you don't make God's word your final authority. This is how you address the situation. Whether it has to do with your marriage, you notice that things are not working right, you begin to speak to your marriage. You begin to speak the word of God to your marriage. Father, in the name of Jesus, I command every strange spirit contending with this marriage, be gone in the name of Jesus. Satan, take your hands off my marriage. Take your hands off my children. You have to exercise your authority. If we don't exercise our authority, natural disasters can destroy us. Natural disaster can sweep us up, unknowing to us that God has given us ability and authority to speak to nature. God has given us ability and authority to speak to nature. Look at Joshua. When Joshua asked the sun to stand still, Joshua spoke to the storm. Joshua spoke to the sun to stand still. Because there was a battle, he spoke. And can I say this to you, people of God? If we speak to nature, God will answer us. If something is about to go wrong in your neighborhood or around your life, and in the natural it looks like you don't know what to do, begin to speak the word of God. Begin to speak the word of God concerning your vision, concerning your assignment. As you speak God's word, you're releasing the energy of God into the atmosphere that will cause things to go right. We'll make things go right by speaking the word of God over it. It's time to speak to the wind and the storms of life. It's time when things are happening around you, you begin to exercise your spiritual authority. In the name of Jesus, this flood is not coming. This tsunami is not coming. This storm is not coming. In the name of Jesus, I speak to the weather in my neighborhood to be normal. In the name of Jesus, I speak to the weather in my neighborhood to be normal. Maybe the snow is coming. You can begin to speak speak to the snow. You can begin to talk to the snow. In the name of Jesus, I speak to this snow to be calm. You can begin to speak. You can speak to the snow. You can speak to the sandstorm. You can speak to things. Maybe there is a fire outbreak in the place, and you begin to pray and speak the word of God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we command this fire to stop. We command this fire outbreak to stop. You're praying. If you don't exercise your spiritual authority over situations, you may lose. You may be the one to be a victim, because God has given us authority to exercise over situation and over evil spirit. Jesus said, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." He has given us the power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy. He said that nothing shall by any means hurt you. Maybe you came from a family where everybody struggled with life. You can begin to speak the word of God over the lineage and begin to decree, Father, in the name of Jesus, I see your blessing on my lineage. I see your blessing on my lineage. There is no struggle here. Where the seed of Abraham will see things working in our favor. If we don't exercise our authority, we are going to lose out. Exercising your authority begins by walking in the revelation of who you are in Christ Jesus. The revelation of who you are in Christ Jesus is the key to walking in spiritual authority. The revelation of who you are in Christ Jesus is the key to walking in spiritual authority. If you want to walk in spiritual authority, you need to know who you are in Christ, what you have in Christ, and what you can do with the Christ in you. You have to know who you are in Christ. We are the seed of Abraham. We are a chosen generation. We are a royal priesthood. We are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. We are the partakers of the divine nature. We are the partakers of the divine nature. So we need to know who we are in Christ Jesus. The knowledge of who we are empowers us to speak with authority. The knowledge of who we are. Now, knowing what you have in Christ Jesus. One of the things you have in Christ Jesus, you have dominion. We have dominion. In Genesis, I need to read this to us. In Genesis chapter 1, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lamb of God. In Genesis chapter 1, I want to show something here I believe is going to help us. In Genesis chapter 1, I'd like to read from verse 26. Let me do it from verse 28. Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. He said, "And God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, and subdue it." God told them, subdue it. Subdue. Don't let it subdue you. We have authority to subdue situation in the natural realm. In the earthly realm, we have the authority as the sons of God to subdue. Now, if we don't use our authority, we can't subdue. We can only subdue when we use our authority. In the name of Jesus, we can speak to the sun, we can speak to the storm, we can speak to opposition, we can speak to contention. So the word of God said here, let them subdue. He said, subdue it and have dominion, and have dominion. This is the will of God, that we walk in dominion. This is the will of God, that we walk in dominion. For we to walk in dominion, we have to function by the word of God. For we to walk in dominion, we need to function by God's word. If we don't function by the word of God, we cannot walk in dominion. If we don't function by the word of God, we cannot walk in dominion. So Paul was writing in Colossians 3:16, he said, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. You know, when he said that line, you know, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Because if the word of God dwells in you richly, it produces boldness. The boldness to walk in dominion. Those who walk in dominion are people who magnify God's word above any situation in the natural. They magnify the word of God above any situation in the natural. They magnify the word of God. So if I don't magnify God's word, I cannot walk in power. If I don't magnify the word of God, I cannot walk in power. If you truly want to walk in power, you need to magnify the word of God above the situation, above the circumstances. He said, let them have dominion. So have dominion over the sea. Come on. Have dominion over the air. Have dominion over nature. Have dominion over your environment so you can speak the word of God. Father, in the name of Jesus, whatever that is going on in this environment that is not in line with your word, we command it to stop in the name of Jesus. We come against every strange spirit acting up in this neighborhood. We command it to cease in the name of Jesus. If we don't exercise our authority over situations, evil spirits will take advantage of us. Evil spirits will take advantage of us because we are not exercising our authority as sons of God. The true sons of God flow in the power of God. I said the true sons of God will flow in the power of God. Learn to exercise authority over fear, over worry, over anxiety, because you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And because you are the righteousness of God, you can speak to that disease. You can speak to that infirmity. You can speak to that situation because we are the sons of God. For we to walk in dominion, we need to dwell in the word of God. Don't forget this, to dwell in the word. Let the word of God determine your mindset. Let God's word determine your communication. I said, let God's word determine your mindset. Let God's word determine your communication. Let God's word determine your mindset. Let God's word determine your communication. If the word of God does not determine your communication, then you'll be doing something that is not consistent with his will. He said, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. And if the word dwells in you richly, then you can express your dominion. You can express your dominion over situations, over circumstances, over issues of life. God's word in your spirit will empower you to take the lead ahead of any situation. I said, God's word in your spirit empowers you to take the lead ahead of any situation. We are here to walk in authority. We have authority in Christ Jesus, and that authority has to be released by faith. I'm going to say this again. I said, we have authority in Christ Jesus, and that authority has to be released by faith. It is by faith we release our authority. It is by faith we speak the word of God with expectation to see a supernatural turnaround. It is by faith we believe God for provision. It is by faith we trust God for supernatural increase. It is by faith we speak the word of God and see supernatural results. Can I say this to you? If you're born again, you have dominion. You have authority. You have influence. You have power. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lamb of God. If you're watching this broadcast right now, you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, the greatest thing you can ever do with your life is to come to Jesus. He helps you walk in authority, in power, and in influence. You can say this after me if you want to receive Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with me, it means you're born again and the Holy Ghost is going to lead you from this day forward. I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. We consistently bring forth God's word every day to people on YouTube, so you can subscribe to be able to receive new teachings that will help you grow in your walk of faith. We also encourage you to keep watching finishworktv.com. Finishworktv.com is a ministry on the cutting edge, helping many people around the world to receive the engrafted word of God. I also encourage you to like my official pages, Apostle Faithman Ogboada on Facebook. That's my official page, Apostle Faithman Ogboada. And also, you can send me friends requests on Faithman Ogboada on Facebook. And I pray that the blessings of the Lord will rest upon you. Today, we encourage you to consider partnering with our ministry, with what we're doing, helping more people to receive the word of God in the nations. And you can partner with us today on PayPal. It's faithmanteaching@gmail.com. This faithmanteaching@gmail.com. Thank you for watching this broadcast. Until I come your way soon, don't ever forget this. You have dominion and authority. There is greatness in you.